Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
In continuation to the last class, from this chapter, Dual Nature of Radiation and Matter, we are going to start exercise problems, ma. Because with our last class, we completed example problems, right? So now we are going to start exercise problems. That's why I started with the number, right, 1, okay? Right. So the chapter is, you know, dual nature of radiation and matter, okay? Right, see here. First problem. Find A, the maximum frequency, B, minimum wavelength of X-rays produced by 30 kilovolt electrons. 30 kilovolt electrons. Okay? Right. So we have to find a maximum frequency and minimum wavelength. Maximum frequency and a minimum wavelength. Okay? Right. See this. So, you can write this statement, that is what maximum energy of X-ray photon is equal to maximum energy of an accelerated electron. Maximum energy of an accelerated electron. See here, ma. See the light, where I am giving the light. Maximum energy of an accelerated electron. Accelerated electron. Okay, right. And based on this, you know, that is what, based on this statement, based on this relation, that is what maximum energy of X-ray photon is equal to maximum energy of an accelerated electron. We can write this expression, that is what, using notations, H nu maximum is equal to E into V, okay, right. Therefore, V maximum is equal to, right, just we are writing that is what nu maximum, right? It is not Vm, it is nu maximum. The same thing whatever is here, that we are writing here, that is what nu maximum is equal to Ev by H. It's a frequency, right? It's a frequency, and you know, by seeing the units also you can decide it's a frequency, right? So nu maximum is equal to Ev by H, right? So mathematical. And substitute the values. It is what, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 into 30 into 10 power 3 divided by 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34, right? Just we are writing the values and we are substituting the values, and then we are getting the calculation. We are doing the calculation, mathematical calculation. It will give us 7.24 into 10 to the power of 18 H, 7.24 into 10 to the power of 18 H, okay, right. And this is what he is asking, maximum frequency, which we got 7.24 into 10 to the power of 18 H, 10 to the power of 18 H, okay, right. Now we are going to see B, that is what he is asking to find. Minimum wavelength of X-rays, right? So first A is maximum frequency, that's we found as 7.24 into 10 to the power of, see this, right? So new maximum is equal to 7.24 into 10 to the power of 18 H. Okay, right. Now wavelength, that is what he is asking. Minimum wavelength, see this, minimum wavelength, right? So minimum wavelength is equal to C by, that is what, new maximum. New maximum, that's just now we found, no, that is what, new maximum. Here C by new maximum, that is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 divided by, that is what we got here, you know, 7.24 into 10 to the power of 18, that is what we got here, maximum frequency. And if you do this mathematical division, we will get it as 0.0414 nanometers, right? 0.0414 nanometers, right? So the answer you can express in our own units, ma, because it is board level problem, no? Suppose the competitive exam problem means, based on the given options, we will decide what is the unit, okay? But here, right, if you want, you can express in meters also. So what is in meters? 0.0414 into 10 to the power of minus 9 meters. And 10 to the power of minus 9 means nano, no? So that you can say 0.0414 nanometers, okay? Right. Next problem, see here. That is what, second problem, second exercise problems, okay? Second exercise problem, see this. The work function of cesium, the work function of cesium metal is 2.14 electron volt, full stop. When light of frequency, 6 into 10 to the power of 14 H, when light of frequency 6 into 10 to the power of 14 H is incident on the metal surface, is incident on the metal surface, okay? See here, metal surface, photo emission of electrons occurs, right? So when this is the light of frequency incident on the metal surface, photo emission of electrons occurs, right? In this situation, based on this situation, observe carefully, they have given two things. One is work function as 2.14 electron volt. Another one is frequency of the incident light, that is 6 into 10 to the power of 14 H. Based on this information and situation, he is asking what is the maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons, A. Three things are there, ma. Three things we have to calculate, right? First, A, maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons. Next, B, stopping potential, right? And C is maximum speed of the emitted photoelectrons. Maximum speed of the emitted photoelectrons, right? So three things we have to calculate, okay? Right. And please keep in mind the situation and the given values. Situation and given values to solve these three things, okay? Right. The situation is, you know, when light of frequency is incident on the metallic surface, photoelectron emission occurs. What is the, right? And the information given is work function is 2.14 electron volt, and incident light frequency is 6 into 10 to the power of 14 H. Okay, that is what, these are the two things given. If you want, you can write here, right? So before going to do the solution or answer, you can write here, that is what, phi naught or W naught. Both we are using to represent work function, right? So either phi naught or W naught is equal to this value, and this is what, new. This is what, new value, that is 6 into 10 to the power of 14 H. Okay, right. And now first we are going to answer for A. See here, maximum kinetic energy, right? Maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons. Maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons. And you know what is the Einstein's photoelectric equation? We know that is what, H nu is equal to, right? E is equal to phi naught plus ke maximum. E is equal to phi naught plus ke maximum, right? So that is the Einstein's photoelectric equation. From that equation, we can write like this, that is what, k maximum is equal to h nu minus w naught. H nu minus w naught, okay? See this. And now H value, you know, 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34. And a new value given 6 into 10 to the power of 14. But if you observe carefully, 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34 in joule second, right? And this is what H. But here W naught, that is work function, they have given as 2.14 electron volts, right? That's why this is in electron volts, means this term also should be, this expression is also should be in electron volt. That's why we are dividing with 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19, right? Okay. And do this process, that is here you, if you complete this calculation, you will get it as 2.48 electron volt, and already minus 2.14 electron volt, right? So 2.48 minus 2.14 is equal to 0.34 electron volt, right? So kinetic, the maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons is 0.34 electron volt, 0.34 electron volt, okay? That's what he is asking in A. And in B, he is asking what is the stopping potential, or calculate the stopping potential, okay? Right. Here, stopping potential is, right, as EV0 is equal to KE maximum, no? As EV0 is equal to K maximum, that is equal to 0.34 electron volt, right? 0.34 electron volt. See here, just now we found K maximum, so that's we are equating to this EV0 is equal to K maximum. Now we can find V0, no? See here, ma, EV0 is equal to 0.34 EV, so EE will get cancelled, no? Then what about V0? V0 is equal to 0.34 volts. 0.34 volts, okay, right. Next, C. Next, because B completed, no? Now we are going to answer for C. See here. And this value, you know, that is a general formula, you know, kinetic energy K is equal to half mv square. So that we are writing K maximum is equal to half into, I mean, 1 by 2 into small m into V maximum square. That is, if you write in joules, 0.34 into 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules, 0.34 into 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules, right? So now you can find V maximum square, no? See, just taking this 2 to that side and multiplied this with 2, divided by, that is what, mass. Right? See here, maximum speed of the emitted photoelectrons. So it is the mass of the electron. And finally, this is what we are getting V maximum square as 11, right? See here, 119,000, right? See here. So 119,560.4 into 10 power 6. This is what V maximum square. But our intention is to find V maximum. So if you do that square root, we will get it as 345.8 into 10 power 3 meter per second, right? And the same thing you can write like this also, ma. 345.8 kilometer per second, right? So it is what he is asking. See here, maximum speed of the emitted photoelectrons, that is what 345.8 kilometer per second, right? Okay. Now see the next problem, third problem. See this. The photoelectric cutoff voltage in a certain experiment. The photoelectric cutoff voltage in a certain experiment is 1.5 volt, full stop. What is the maximum kinetic energy of photoelectrons emitted? Right? Observe carefully. They have given, right, the photoelectric cutoff voltage, right? The photoelectric cutoff voltage in a certain experiment is 1.5 volt, okay? full stop. What is the maximum kinetic energy of photoelectrons emitted? Photoelectrons emitted, okay, right. See this, this relation we know, K maximum is equal to E V naught, right, that is equal to, you know, 1.5 electron volt, right, because here E is there, no, so that is equal to 1.5 electron volt. V naught is equal to this value, that is what, 1.5 V, but E V naught is equal to 1.5 E V. That we are converting into joules. So 1.5 into 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. So do this multiplication. Finally, we can write it as 2.4 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. 2.4 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. This is the maximum kinetic energy of photoelectrons emitted. Maximum kinetic energy of photoelectrons emitted by having this value, we found as 2.4, we calculated as 2.4 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. Okay, right. Next problem, see here. Next problem, that is what? Fourth exercise problem, see here. Monochromatic light of wavelength 632.8 nanometers is produced by a helium neon laser, is produced by a helium neon laser, right, full stop. See here, see this, the power emitted is, 9.42 milliwatt. So it's a given information, right? So this is what wavelength of monochromatic light, that is 632.8 nanometers and produced by helium neon laser. Okay, right, it is the source of light and the power emitted is 9.42 milliwatts. They have given two things, ma. One is wavelength of the incident light and power emitted, that is 9.42 milliwatt. Now, asking to find three things, right? First, A is the find the energy and momentum. Find the energy and momentum of each photon in the light beam. Find the energy and momentum of each photon in the light beam, right? So we have to find energy and momentum of each photon, right? Next, B is how many, right? Next, B is how many photons per second, how many photons per second on the average, how many photons per second on the average arrive at a target irradiated by this beam. So we have to calculate how many number of photons, right, how many photons per second on the average arrive, on the average arrive, okay, at a target irradiated by this beam. In the bracket they have given assumption, ma, that's also we have to keep in mind. Assume the beam to have uniform cross section. Assume the beam to have uniform cross section which is less than the target area, which is the, which is the beam should have, the beam to have uniform cross section which is less than the target area, right? Okay. And there is one more thing, that is what, third. See here, how fast does a hydrogen atom have to travel in order to have the same momentum as that of the proton? How fast does a hydrogen atom have to travel in order to have the same momentum as that of the proton? Okay, see here. So three things he is asking to find by giving certain information, that is monochromatic light of wavelength 632.8 nanometers, and then power emitted by, okay, power emitted is 9.42 milliwatts, right? First we are going to discuss about A. See, in A what he is asking to find? Find the energy and momentum of each photon in the light beam. See here. Energy of each photon, what is the formula? E is equal to hc by lambda. E is equal to hc by lambda, right? So h value we know, and C value and by lambda value, that is what this value, right? So these two we are taking in SI units, that's why this also we have to take in SI unit. So that do this mathematical process, we will get it as 3.14 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. And he is also asking to calculate momentum, energy over, but what about the momentum? P is equal to H by lambda. H value we know, that is in joule second SI unit, and lambda value we have to take in SI unit, 632.8 into 10 to the power of minus 9 meters. Okay, right. And do this division, we will get it as 1.05 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kg meter per second. Okay, right. So A complete. Now B. In B, we have to calculate number of photons arriving per second at the target. So the formula is N is equal to P by E. N is equal to P by E. And P already given, ma, that is what power 9.42 milliwatt. So milliwatt is not the SI unit, that's why we are writing 9.42 into 10 to the power of minus 3 watt divided by 3.14 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. That is what energy here we calculated, right? So if we do the division, so we will get it as 3 into 10 to the power of 16. 3 into 10 to the power of 16, right? So what I am saying is, 3 into 10 to the power of 16 photons per second. 3 into 10 to the power of 16 photons per second. Photons per second, right? According to the given question, that is what B, number of photons arriving. Number of photons arriving per second. Arriving per second, okay? Right. Next, C, momentum of a hydrogen atom. Okay, right. See what he is asking. How fast does a hydrogen atom to have to travel in order to have the same momentum as that of the proton, right? And you know, if you equate the momentum of proton, this now you can equate, no, according to the question we can write this statement, that is what you can write this relation: momentum of a hydrogen atom is equal to momentum of a photon, right? Then what about velocity? See here, so velocity is that P by M. So P is already we got 1.05 into 10 to the power of minus 27 divided by, that is what mass, 1.67 into 10 to the power of minus 27. 1.67 into 10 to the power of minus 27. So that we will get it as 0.63 meter per second. 0.63 meter per second. This is what velocity v. Okay. Right, next question, that is what question number 5, see here. The energy flux of sunlight reaching the surface area, the energy flux of sunlight reaching the surface of the earth is 1.388 into 10 to the power of 3 watt per meter square. Right, see here, ma. The energy flux of the sunlight reaching the surface area of the earth is 1.388 into 10 to the power of 3 watt per meter square, full stop. How many photons, see here, ma, how many photons nearly per square meter are incident on the earth per second? That we have to calculate. How many photons nearly per square meter are incident on the earth per second? Okay, next. They have given one small assumption that we have to consider. Assume that the protons in the sunlight have an average wavelength of 550 nanometers. 550 nanometers. Okay. Right. So this is also like a given information, that is what wavelength of sunlight is 550 nanometers. And here they have given, that is what energy flux, right? And he is asking to find how many photons per square meter are incident on the earth per second. Right. See the answer. First, we are going to calculate energy of each photon, because we need This is the formula to calculate number of photons incident on the Earth's surface per second per square meter. This is the formula, right? So that is equal to total energy per square meter per second divided by energy of each photon, right? It's okay, it is the given value, 1.388 into 10 to the power of 3 watt per meter square. But this value we don't know, this we have to calculate. That is what total energy per square meter per second. Okay. See this. This value they have given. This value they have given. This value we have to find. Energy of each photon. Energy of each photon. So energy of each photon, E is equal to hc by lambda. E is equal to hc by lambda. That is equal to, 6.63 into 10 to the power of minus 34 into 3 into 10 to the power of 8 divided by 550 nanometers. But we can't take it as directly, because the numerator is in SI unit, denominator should be in SI. That's why we have written, observe carefully, 550 into 10 to the power of minus 9, 550 into 10 to the power of minus 9 meters, and do this mathematical division, then you will get as, you will get it as 3.62 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules, minus 19 joules, okay. Right. So now we got energy of each photon, and now we can calculate, that is whatever he is asking, that is number of photons incident on the Earth's surface per second per square meter. Okay. That is equal to total energy per square meter per second divided by energy of each photon. Okay. And this is the value they have given, that is 1.388 into 10 to the power of 3. Divided by this value just now we got 3.62 into 10 to the power of minus 19. So if we do this mathematical division, we will get it as 3.8 into 10 to the power of 21. 3.8 into 10 to the power of 21. So these many number of photons incident on Earth's surface per second per square meter, per second per square meter, okay, right. And this problem is application to daily life, because sunlight, right, and Earth, and we are living on surface of Earth, right. So this problem is application to daily life, app. That's why, so this problem also helps us when we are going to solve another problems, and this problem also helps us to think in our own way, right. Okay, so in this class we started exercise problems from dual nature of radiation and matter chapter, right. In our previous class we completed example problems, that's why in this class we started exercise problems, okay, right. So we discussed 5 exercise problems, that is what problem number 1, we calculated maximum frequency and minimum wavelength of X-rays based on the given value. In the second problem, we calculated, based on the given information, we calculated maximum kinetic energy of the emitted electrons, and then stopping potential, and then maximum speed of the emitted photoelectrons. Thereafter, in the third problem, we calculated maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons emitted by using this formula, K maximum is equal to E V naught. And based on the given value, as V naught is equal to 1.5 electron volt. V naught is equal to 1.5 volt, and E V naught is equal to 1.5 electron volt. Next, in the fourth problem, based on the given information, right, we calculated energy and momentum of each photon in a light beam, and in B we calculated number of photons per second, right, arrived at the target. And in C, we calculated the speed of hydrogen atom. How fast does a hydrogen atom have to travel in order to have the same momentum? Just comparison. Okay. So here, A, B, C. Next, in the last problem, in this class, the last problem, fifth problem, we calculated number of photons incident on the Earth's surface per second per square meter. Okay. You know, our head is, what is the surface area, right? So that you can imagine, square meter means you can imagine, in square meter these many number of photons are going to incident. that is 3.8 into 10 to the power of 21 number, okay, because it is a number, no, so no unit, okay, right. So in our next class we will start with the sixth exercise problem. Thank you.